Alright, hi YouTube, this is Presidential Tourist back in another video, and I'm at Leu Gardens for their Dinosaur Invasion event. Actually ends in a few days, like April 30th, and we come across our first dinosaur. Looks pretty cool. Pretty small eyeball for a such a large dinosaur. I don't know if I'll film every one, but I'll definitely get as many as I can, and I'll take some pictures too. But I'll give you a good idea about which ones. Now this here is a Daspletosaur, meaning frightful lizard, carnivore. I think it's cool that they have signs here giving you different information about each dinosaur, which kind of reminds me of Dinosaur World and Plant City. And if you check out my playlist, you see a whole bunch of videos from there. I'm mainly only going to be filming for this event. But I plan to come here, do more with the gardens, and then they have a museum here, but there'll be a separate visit. Here's our first dinosaur. Now at my second dinosaur, this is a high Psittacibema. I'll show you the sign in a second. Good size one. That big old eye on him. Now that eye seems bigger with regard to his body size than the first one we shown. This is listed as number 2 on the map. And here's the sign. Late Cretaceous period, 75 million years ago, and his meaning of his name is High Step. And he was a herbivore. Lucky for us, because he was a carnivore, he might come over here and try to eat me. That wouldn't be good at all. And look, there's a thing of eggs back there. It's a mama. Aww, did you just give birth to some eggs? I'm a big fan of dinosaurs and reptiles, so I think they're all adorable looking. That's the second one, and there's 13 all together. Hopefully I'll get a chance to get them all during this trip, but this event ends in a few days actually. Sunday, I think, is the last day, the 30th. Been going on since, January 13th. Here's our third dinosaur. This is a Dimetrodon. Now doesn't it look like he has a Pringle on his back? I remember seeing something on like Discovery Channel that was used for like mating and against other males too. Make you look bigger than you really were, and it might have been used to cool or heat up blood throughout the body. I think more of cooling it. That's why that sail is really on there, if I remember correctly. And here's the sign. And he was in the Permian 251 million years ago, and the meaning of the name is two shapes of teeth. And he was a carnivore. He's the third one on the list. Pretty cool, I gotta tell you. Leu Gardens here, it's a beautiful place. It's like 50 acres, so there's a lot to see. So I'm definitely gonna have to come back. Definitely gonna have to come back and film the gardens more, but for now I'm just gonna do the dinosaurs. took a bit, but I finally found the next one. This is number 4. It is called the Bambi Raptor. So basically, a Bambi from Disney was a dinosaur. That's what he would look like. There's 1, 2, at least 3 of those little guys in there. And the sign. Late Cretaceous, 75 million years ago. Raptor means thief. The undiscoverer named it Bambi after the Disney character. Cool. And that's number 4. Now let's push on to the next one. Hopefully you'll be able to find all of them. And if you look, wait a minute, before I go. Look at that, there's actual a gnoll sticking his little dewlap out on top of the Bambi Raptor. Pretty cool. Here's the next one. This is Sordes, if I'm saying it right. Late Jurassic, 155 million years ago. Meaning of name, devil or hairy devil. He was a carnivore. Probably why he's crawling up there, so sometimes, well, see, he has kind of like a wing-like thing. I think what they did is they would glide from tree to tree. At least I've seen something like that with a similar dinosaur on Discovery Channel. Not sure if the same kind did that. But you would definitely miss this one if you weren't looking carefully, because he's quite small. Here's the sign. Yeah, what I see here, and I see this at other gardens, it has these type of plant. People scratch their name in them. At Hollis Gardens, they had these, and those every space had their name scratched on it. Fortunately, people do that. But there, that one is. Pretty cool. Hey, this place is incredible. This definitely is a hell of a lot better than some of the other places I've been to. Except maybe Bach Towers. This is definitely better than Hollis Gardens, I know that. Anyways, that's the next one. It's number 5. Now let's find number 6. See you in a minute. Here's number 6 on the list. It's a Placerius, period, late Triassic. 221, 210 million years ago. Mean of name is mammal-like reptile, 2 dog teeth. He's a herbivore. Pretty cool. There he is. Look at that guy. Yeah, the front kind of looks, like, I guess, kind of like a dog. Maybe almost like a pig, too. That's definitely, with the horn and the 2 teeth sticking out, it's probably would be pretty terrifying if you saw one of those in real life a little bit. You know, I think he's adorable looking. Like you said, I love reptiles. A lot of walking to find these places, these different dinosaurs, but it's worth it. Like I said, I'm definitely coming back. Film the gardens and then the museum. Actually, film the gardens will probably take several trips, but this is like 50 acres. But I definitely want to do the dinosaurs like what I'm doing now. I've been a fan of dinosaurs since I was a little kid. Of course, most people are. All right, here's number 6, the Placerius. Probably butchering a lot of these names. Now on to number 7. Here's number 7. This is a Paracephalus. I know I'm saying that wrong, but I definitely remember this dinosaur from Discovery Channel. especially with Nigel Marvin on his one of his shows that he did. If you don't know who he is, just look him up. He does a lot with animals and especially extinct stuff, but he's kind of like a smaller version of, his name escapes me, man. The one who does narration for, like, Planet Earth, Planet Earth 2. But, so this is a pretty famous dinosaur, late Cretaceous, 75 to 65 million years ago, meaning a name near-crested lizard, and he was a herbivore. A lot of other facts on him in these signs, but I'm not going to read them all right now. Another thing cool about walking through these gardens is a lot of the different plants are named. They have a little sign telling you what kind it is, which I think is cool. But like I said earlier, I'm just concentrating on the dinosaurs now, but I thought I'd point that out. Okay, now on to number 8. See you in a minute. Pretty awesome. This is number 8. This is the city patty. And you see it has like a little egg pile there. Pretty cool. Another one with those feathers, so they might have been the kind that would climb up trees and then glide from tree to tree. I'm not an expert on this, so don't take my word for it. And here's the sign, late Cretaceous, 84 to 75 million years ago, and the meaning of the name is Pyra Lord. It was omnivore, ate both meats and plants. Look how adorable that thing looks. The way the beak is black and it's a little bit colorful on the head, kind of reminds me of that one bird you'd see like in Fruit Loops. Okay, well, on to the next one, number 9, which is Allosaurus, so it should be a big one. Here's our 9th dinosaur on the list, Allosaurus. It looks like he has some babies with him. Look how fearsome that dude looks. I'm here on, I think it was either the BBC or Discovery Channel did a whole special on the Allosaurus alone. Here's the sign. Allosaurus, late Jurassic, 155 to 150 million years ago. Different lizard. He was a carnivore. All right, now on to number 11, I think. But number 11, we're almost done. Here, number 10, the Heterodosaurus I'm not going to try to say it. Period late Jurassic to early Jurassic, 200 to 195 million years ago. And the meaning of the name is different tooth lizard. Just a couple small little guys. And they have it next to the, at the prehistoric plant section. Let me show you that quickly. It's a sign. Cicades. And I think this is pretty cool. Now here's the next one. This is number 11, the Compsognathus. Probably saying it really bad. Late Jurassic period, 155 to 147 million years ago. Meaning the name, elegant jaw, diet, carnivore. Insects, lizards, small mammals. There he is. This is a little guy. Pretty cool. No, actually, then there's one more here. Actually, three of them. Interesting seeing these dinosaur statues with little knolls running around them. Right, on to the next one. Alright, here's I think number 12, the Quetzalcoatlus, late Cretaceous period, 70-65 million years ago. Meaning a name named after feathered serpent god of the Aztecs, and the diet was a carnivore. There he is, right here. Pretty cool. I didn't catch it on camera, but a minute ago I saw a whole bunch of turtles on the bank behind me by the lake. And right when I'm pulling up the camera, it's like they knew, and most of them went into the water. Too bad it would have made a cool shot. I was only able to catch one of them on camera that I took a picture of. This is number 12. It's right by this dock area. All right, I got one more. Well, I did a pretty big achievement. Found the 13th and final dinosaur, the Centaurus, late early Jurassic, 208 million years ago, meaning of name, fused ankle, and he was a carnivore. Pretty cool. Very happy I was able to show all 13 dinosaurs to you all. I'm not sure this is a regular event they do every year or not, but oh, look. Just trying to get that one to eat. Looks like he just made it. That one's jumping up into the air to get him. Must be pretty hungry. And here's the list of all of them. It's pretty awesome. In the map. Well, hopefully you could see me okay. I'm using my other camera. I can't actually see the little screen on because mine just battery just pooped out after I finished filming the last dinosaur here at Leu Gardens. But I very much enjoyed myself. I definitely plan on coming back. I want to film a whole bunch of the gardens and then show the museum that they have here. But like I said, I won't be doing that now. This place is too big to do the dinosaurs and do a whole bunch of filming of the gardens itself. And then the museum too. This is, like I said, this is like 50 acres long, or 50 acres big. So there's a lot here to film, so I'm definitely going to be coming back. Hopefully within a month, I'll show off the garden some more, and then eventually we'll get to the museum too. I'm really looking forward to the museum, I'm always a big fan of different museums. But other than that, that's it. This is the dinosaur event they had here at Leu Gardens. It went from, I think, January 13th to the end of April, April 30th. So I just caught it in time. I've only had it for like a few days left. That's why I wanted to make sure. I've been meaning to come here for like the last couple months or so to film these dinosaurs. And I finally made it. I'm happy. I'm a huge, big fan of dinosaurs. Huge fan of dinosaurs. That's why places like this has events like this and Dinosaur World. I just enjoy going to them. Check out my channel. I did a whole bunch of filming at Dinosaur World if dinosaurs is your thing. I also filmed the Discover the Dinosaurs Traveling Museum that goes all over the country. I filmed it about a year or so ago when they stopped at Lakeland. They were in Orlando like a couple months ago, and I'm sure they'll come back to Florida again soon. But I did some good filming on that. I did some other dinosaur themed events on my channel, and there's a few I'm going to do in the future that I know that's taking place now and coming up. So look forward to that if dinosaurs is your thing. You get a chance to check out the rest of my channel. I have a lot of different themed videos, a lot of nature stuff like this, zoos. I do a lot of tourist attractions too, like Disney, Gatorland. I do a lot of different museums, big and small. I just do food reviews too is another big thing. So I do a big variety. I guess this is like a variety channel. I like to keep it fresh and do different things. So this is another reason why I'm here too. But thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. And if you have any questions about this event, please let me know. I'm always happy to answer your questions about anything you may want to ask. And I look forward to talking to all of you soon again. And it means a lot to me that you took the time to watch this video and any of my other videos, because time is the most precious commodity that we have on this earth. So that you took the time to watch this video, you're willing to spend some of that precious commodity on this video and spend this time here with me, it means a lot to me. I know I might not be the most exciting guy in the world, but I always found myself to be, I know, low-key basically. And I know that might not be too exciting, but this is how I am. Again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Bye, everybody. Bye.